This RPA system video shows you how to create a new submission in the New South Wales Restrictive Practices Authorisation System. Start by clicking on the participant link in the menu bar. Search for the participant. Open their record by clicking on the hyperlink on the participant's name. Then click on the Create RPA Form button at the bottom of the page. As soon as you have clicked on Create RPA Form, a draft submission will be created and can be found via the RPA Submission menu item. Each submission has its own unique ID number, and note that the status at this stage is draft. Please note that you can navigate through the different sections of the submission by clicking on the relevant sections in the floating menu bar on the right-hand side of the page. The first section of the submission is the NDIS participant details. This is pre-populated from the information already entered in the participant menu item. Scroll down to section 2, Restrictive Practice Category. Enter the Behaviour Support Plan expiry date. This is a mandatory field. You will need to enter the NDIS Behaviour Support Plan ID that has been provided by the NDIS Quality and Safeguards Commission. This is also a mandatory field. If you don't have this information yet, you can come back and complete these fields. However, please note that you won't be able to release the form until all mandatory fields have been completed. Choose the submission type. For this video, we are selecting a planned authorisation. Section 3 shows prior RPA history. This section will contain links to other restrictive practices authorisations that have been completed in the RPA system by your organisation for the participant. Click Save. This means that all information you have entered so far has been saved and you can come back to the submission form at any time. Other sections of the RPA submission form will be covered in separate videos. Thank you.